there, it's me, Katie Beth again. Check out this quick video of some zero hats I made for Halloween and a quick tutorial on how I made them. But first, check out this video of this little cutie wearing a hat I sent him. So cute. So this is me starting the top of the hat. Kind of looks like a little yarmulke at the top. And then I just started adding on some sides. And then I add on some more to the side. Now my goal with this particular hat was that I wanted to make it really flowy so that the ghost part of the body was actually the hat. And then I added on the rest of his head onto the top so that the hat's actually the ghost body and his head is on right on top of your head if you were wearing it. Now I was making this hat for a toddler and I thought because I had made it so flowy it might be too big for him. So I actually went through and took some ribbon and weaved the ribbon through to sort of make a drawstring on it. Giving a quick view on how I weaved the ribbon through with my crochet hook there. And this is what the drawstring looks like. You can pull it really loose. And then you can pull it really tight. So it can really fit any type of face. And here's an example of me making it really tight on her so it fits snugly. And here's what the hat looks like from a few different angles. And that was hat number one. Now hat number two, which actually the little cutie in the beginning was modeling this hat. It's made more like a snowboarding hat with the snowboarding ear covers. And then I just went through and put the nose on the top of the hat, put some eyes on there. And in this picture here, I'm sewing on the ears. Now when I'm making pieces for hats, I always leave a little extra tail when I start so that I can use it to sew pieces together. And that's what I'm using here is the end tail, just sewing the ears onto the head. Once I was finished sewing the ear onto the head, I had a little extra string left over from the tail. So I hid that by kind of sewing it through the other pieces of crochet that I had already done. And as you can see that here, I just sew it through and then I nip off the end. And then you just mirror image the other side the exact same way you did the first side, sewing the ears on and then hiding any extra string. And then after I had the initial ears sewn on, I wanted it to have that little fluff in the bend, and so I decided where I wanted it to go, and then sewed that on, and mirror imaged the other side as best as I could. This is what it looks like with his ears complete. And the only step I have left is to sew on his nose. Now for his nose, I crocheted a little pumpkin. And then I just sew the nose right on. And don't worry about the orange thread showing through the nose. It won't even matter because the nose and pumpkin are so close, it just matches right up. That's a wrap for hat number two, and if you have any comments, please leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching.